Not again.
It's 2:30, you bum. I've been awake since 7 this morning.
I was closing at 7 this morning.
Seriously?
Yeah, we found a dead guy in the John. I had to wait for the cops.
I'd have just left him there.
That's because your compassion knows no bounds, Reggie.
Anyway, what are you doing tonight?
I was thinking of sleeping.
Dreaming? A little more sleeping?
Don't give me that shit.
It's Friday. Neither of us got shit to do. Tomorrow's your day off.
I'm trying to sleep, Reggie.
Drink some Red Bull.
Eat some bananas. You want some Coke? Because I'm sure.
Sure, I got some laying around here somewhere.
What time?
See, I knew you wanted to.
What time, Reggie?
So, I was thinking we could meet at the bar around 8:30, 9, maybe 9, 9:30.
Fine. Yep. See you then.
Now you can go back to sleep for a couple of hours.
I'm awake now, thanks.
By the way,
you still want that Coke? Because I can bring it.
I'll see you then, Reggie. Can anybody hear me? Can anybody hear me?
Where am I? You're in hospital, sir. Did something happen to me? What do you remember? I remember. I can't remember anything. I remember waking up tied to a fucking hospital bed. A little confusion can be forgiven. According to the witness reports, you went to the bathroom following a coffee, and on the way back to your table, your footing became unstable and you fell.
What was it? Was it a stroke or something?
We're still looking into that.
There are a few possibilities. I believe you were drugged.
Drugged? Who drugged me? Oh, my wife, my ex.
I'm supposed to be her person.
She was here.
She's still here.
Can I see her?
Of course. Luck, she just woke up.
Call?
She can't hear you, sir. Now she can. She can hear you, but she can't see you. You can see her, but you can't hear her. I find that this works best.
What the fuck are you talking about?
You still love your ex-wife, sir.
Excuse me?
Do you, Mr. Julius Bernard, love your ex-wife, one Miss Nicole Fig?
Oh, of course I did.
Did?
Yeah. Divorce genius.
cannot escape my attention, sir. Believe me. So you're saying that any emotion or affection you feel for this young lady is strictly in the past tense. Is that what I am to believe?
What the hell's that got to do with anything?
It has everything to do with everything. It's why we're here.
Okay, right, look, I get it, but it's a pretty difficult question to answer.
You were married for?
5 years.
How long have you been divorced?
A little over a year.
And in the time since your divorce, you have been intimate with how many other women?
What?
I know when you're lying, Julius.
None?
In over a year. Forgive me. You're right. I'm sorry. Who am I? I am hardly the one to judge. If it makes you feel any better, Nicole hasn't been with another man since. And I think you can probably guess the answer to that question, can't you? You did care for her, didn't you? Enough for her to be the last person that you've ever loved.
Yes.
I'm going to be completely honest with you now, Julius. Considering what you're about to go through, honesty is the least I can offer. The next 5 days will be the worst, the most demeaning and painful of your life. Because, sir, for the next 4 of those 5 days, I will inflict upon you the most torturous acts that it is possible for one man to commit upon another. Unspeakable things. And then, on the 5th day, when you think there is nothing left for me to do with you, I will kill you. And then I will go down to the morgue and set her free. I promise you, Julius. Let her go then. That is not how this needs to be, though, sir. Not at all. You are still in control. Believe it or not, sir. You can stop this at any point. Literally, at any point. You can stop it right now, if you like. Before I have done any of these things I promised. All you have to do is say enough, and I will stop. And then I will go down to the morgue. And I'll kill her. And you will watch. And she, having heard all this, will know that you were the one who condemned her. Life is all about questions, sir. Ones we dare not speak out loud. These are the questions that you're going to have to ask yourself now, Julius. How much did you love that woman? Do you still love her? Because in 5 days or less, you will be able to answer that question. And you will answer it with somebody's life. Welcome to day one. This is the only day that I will go easy on you. Perceive the outside world, because let's be honest, sir,
be the point of that.
I'm telling you, man, you just gotta be zen.
What?
Zen, with the ladies.
Of course we're talking about women. When do we talk about anything else?
See, your problem is you wear every failure you ever had as some sort of feather boa or something.
Why am I wearing a feather boa?
You're not. It's in your mind.
So I'm not wearing a feather boa.
You're wearing it internally.
That sounds horrifying.
Look, you just gotta not let it be that important. You just gotta let it fall off you. Like water's off a duck's back.
Pretty proud of yourself, aren't you?
For what?
You know, putting feathers and water and duck and all that shit in the same sentence.
A tiny bit. But there was a point to it, though.
What, I get laid more than you did?
Not just that. We have dates.
Why do you always do this?
Look, she insisted on a double date, and you're the only one of my friends I can call on.
Have a look at me. I look halfway homeless. I smell like a bar. I smell like my bar.
Look, just be cool, okay? All I'm asking you to do is run a little bit of interference. Just be nice enough so whoever she brings is happy. I'm not asking you to fall in love. Just be the duck.
Be the duck.
The duck. The zen duck. Just be the duck.
Okay, I'll be the zen duck, but it's the last time.
It's the last time I'm gonna let you be the zen duck.
Good.
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 Get your drink. Come with me. She's here. I thought you were coming over.
I spilled my drink.
Kira, this is Jules, my best friend in the whole entire world.
Hi.
Jules, this is Kira, the love of my life.
Shut the fuck up, Reggie.
I like her.
Hello. You didn't know you were going on a date, did you?
What? Of course he did. He was here before me.
I'm really sorry. If it's any consolation, this probably won't be lasting long.
Hey!
It's fine. It's totally fine.
Anyway, didn't you bring one for him?
Bring one? What is she, a milkshake?
You know what
Yeah, I know what you mean. She's parking. She'll be with us soon.
Is that her now?
Yeah, that's her.
And this is,
Nicole.
Right, Nicole. Nicole, this is Julius, my best friend in the whole entire world. He's great.
Don't let that bother you. He actually seems nice.
So, I'll just leave you two crazy cats to it then.
I'm sorry he forgot your name.
Don't worry about it. He's not here for me. I'm sure I'll remember it next time.
No, probably not. He's actually a bit of an ass.
Well, he's your friend. You're allowed to say that about him.
Give it some time. You'll get there. You know, when I first met him, he kept calling me Caesar, like he was the first person I would think about. It's so annoying. You want a drink?
Yes.
What are you having?
I used to do bar work.
It sucks, don't it?
Actually, I enjoyed it. I used to pretend like I was one of those old-timey bartenders from the black and white movies.
That's cute. Do you have to go?
No. Kira said she'd text me if things weren't, you know.
Designated plan B.
Exactly. Kind of like how you're here to keep me busy, so I leave Kira alone.
Well, as you can see, I wasn't really expecting a date.
Yeah, but you do smell really bad. And I smell the insides of some really shitty locker rooms.
Well, you are gonna have to cut me some slack. Because I moved a corpse today. Besides, what the hell are you doing in really shitty locker rooms?
That's kind of the drawback for what I do for a living.
Office temping.
No, that's my, you know, job. Not my real job.
What's your real job?
I'm a fighter.
What, like a firefighter.
Not firefighter. You like Muay Thai. Yeah.
What, you fight in a ring?
Yeah, I fight in a boxing ring.
You fight women in a ring?
Yeah.
Wow. Well, you are officially the most interesting yet potentially dangerous woman I have ever met. Do you need to save her?
No, she said she's expecting to stay another hour. Your boy's doing something right somehow.
Sometimes he does.
Do you need us to call you a cab?
No, I'm fine.
No problem. See you soon. Good night.
Night.
Nice to meet you. We'll see you soon.
Hey, man. I got a second date.
I don't believe you.
I did. I got a second date.
How did you get a second date?
Hey, what do you mean? I got a second date.
I got a second date.
No way. Seriously?
I got a second date.
No. No way. Not you.
You're obviously not listening. I said I've got a second date. What do you mean, not me?
You owe me for this.
Yeah, I do. I owe you a kick in the ass.
Ow! Man, this is all me. I hooked you up.
Oh, you keep talking. I'll just walk along and you can talk really loudly and listen to yourself.
He only took one finger. Your wedding finger.
How kind of him.
Thank you.
hope coffee's okay.
No, coffee's good. Thanks.
He told you we screwed on the couch, didn't he?
What did you do that for?
What did I do?
Come on, guys. Can I use your bathroom?
Bathroom's at the end of the hall.
Thank you.
I think he's okay.
Look, I'm sure it's not the first time he's ever been embarrassed into embarrassing himself. He's my best friend. You do the math. And I may have told him.
Ouch! I knew it! Why'd you lie to me?
I didn't lie. I kind of half lied. I didn't tell him that we had sex on both couches.
You were going to let me think I'd embarrassed myself in front of your best friend.
But I didn't. Did I?
You have arrived. Why are you here?
It's who I am. I love it.
If you misunderstand your mind, you will be an ordinary fighter. If you understand your mind, you will be a champion.
Thank you.
They live here. Sit in your corner. Let courage lead your way.
Us.
You're ready.
Us.
How's Nicole?
She's good.
When's she up?
Next.
When's next?
Actually, not lying. When I used to go over and visit as a kid, it was like walking into a pitch battle where sometimes Nintendo happened.
With all due respect, dude, if shit went down, I'd rather have Nicole in my corner than you.
See? He'd just walk away from 20 years of friendship just like that.
To live? Hell yes.
Do you guys want to ride?
No, we actually have plans.
Plans?
Mm-hmm. Julia's got us a table at the place down there.
The Italian place.
You sly but unoriginal chum, are you?
Good night.
Oh, you know I will.
Should you be in ice, like an ice bath?
Yeah, probably.
You sore?
A little bit.
That was brutal.
I know, but it's fun.
It's fun?
Yeah.
I can tell you that.
I am very sorry for the delay.
That's okay. Accidents happen.
Not in my establishment. They do not. The next one out of the door is yours. And the meal is on the house.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I bet they still charge us for the wine.
He said it was on the house.
No, he said the meal was for free. I am very perceptive.
Is that like your superpower?
I'm perceptive, not psychic. You know, Kara really likes Reggie.
Really?
Yeah.
How can you tell?
Little things.
Like?
Like how he was the one sitting between you and her at the fights.
Isn't that just how our tickets worked out?
No, if she'd wanted to, she'd have insisted on sitting in the middle. She likes doing that because if she gets bored with one person, the other person's easy to talk to.
Makes sense. So this superpower,
does it work on people you know, or does it work on anyone?
Yeah, pretty much anyone.
Really?
Yeah.
What about someone in here?
Take those two over there.
I'd say grandchildren.
You'd lose big.
What?
Yeah. Look. Every time he looks away, she sighs or rolls her eyes. And he looks away way too much. They're bored with each other. Keeping up the ruse until they can figure a way out. I give them another 2 months.
This just got depressing.
It doesn't exactly go down well at family gatherings and birthday parties.
Dinner dates.
Mm. Yeah. Weddings.
Funerals,
yeah.
Well, I won't ask you what I was about to ask you then.
Which was?
How long do you think we'll last?
We haven't even officially said we're dating.
Do I need to ask?
No. I'm gonna say 5 years.
5 years?
5 years. With a possible extension period after that point.
Ooh. It sounds like you're hedging your bets.
You're not allowed to bet on yourself.
Have a nice night tonight.
So did I.
What?
Nothing. It's just you're weird.
Thanks.
I don't mean it in a bad way. I mean, you're hard to read and... Yeah. That should bug me, but I kind of like it.
So you don't know what I want to do right now?
Did I?
No.
plumbing issues at work.
Really?
Yeah. One of the bathrooms has been pissing all over the customers. It's actually quite funny. What happened to your eye?
Training injury, my fault.
What do you want to do? You want to go out?
Actually, you know what? I had a really lousy training session today, and then I find out that the fight I had coming up that could have moved me onto pros has been canceled.
Yeah.
And then I get into a fight with my dad over the phone because he won't go to the doctor in case I come back hooked up. We have sex.
What?
Well, it's not that just being around you wouldn't make me feel better, but, you know, a really bad day needs something really good to happen.
Come here.
You know, counterbalance it.
I don't have a choice, do I?
Can I put the TV on?
It's a little role reversal.
I don't want to watch it. I just like background noise. So can I put the TV on or no?
You can put the TV on.
You want to hear something funny?
Do you want me to put on Comedy Central?
No. Do you want to hear something funny about you and me?
Sure.
You know the night we met?
Of course.
When Kara met Reggie. I didn't want to come that night.
Why?
Because... You know, Kara said she was meeting this guy who seemed like an idiot, and I just assumed you'd be an idiot, too. Why did you come?
Well, because Reggie would have kept bugging me till I said yes.
So if I'd have gone with my first instinct and you had more of a backbone, we would have never met.
That's one way of looking at it.
What's another way?
I don't know. I don't have a backbone.
This doesn't bother you, does it?
No. I'm fine. I'm
fine. Sorry, I didn't mean it. I didn't mean to.
Wait. I'm sorry about just now. I didn't mean to hurt your arm. It's just I don't know what the fuck is going on. Will you talk to me? Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I couldn't let you go hungry 2 days in a row.
What's your name?
Samson.
Samson?
Yeah, I know, it's stupid.
Oh, I like it. That's unusual. Samson, can I ask you about Julius?
I'm not supposed to talk to you.
Is he alive?
Yeah, he's alive. The only way he'd be dead right now is if something screwed up.
What is he doing to him?
I'm not supposed to talk to you.
How long has he been doing this?
Longer than I've been here. And I've been here for...
How did he find us?
He has his ways. I'm never involved in the selection process. I need to go. I'm not supposed to talk to you. He'll be here soon. I'll see you tomorrow.
Welcome to day 3, sir. The day the gloves go on.
Quack.
Congratulations on surviving the first 2 days. However, I must warn you that no one has ever gone past this stage.
Quack.
All you have to do is say enough, and it's over. Enough?
Just say enough, and it's all over. Enough?
Fuck.
Is it really worth it? Enough! Say enough, and then you're free to go. Whack! She wouldn't do it for you, would she? She wouldn't say that for you, would she? Say enough! Enough?
Fuck!
Enough! Enough! Say enough, and then it's free to go.
Whack! 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 Whack!
Enough! Say enough, sir! And then we'll see how well that whore runs around after I cut her fucking head off!
Quack.
Hope it's a rental.
Is that a rental?
No, but I'm an erotic pirate. It's kind of
guy. Yeah, I get your point.
I love being married.
You married a day.
But what a day.
Yeah, you did good. She did good, too. You did better.
Thanks, man. Bitch! When I say whoa, you say yeah, whoa.
Yeah!
Whoa?
Yeah!
Okay, y'all, listen up. This is the part of the night where the groom gives a speech and thanks everyone for coming. It's also the part of the night where he says he's gonna keep it short and sweet. But everyone here knows that I love giving speeches, so this is gonna be long. First of all, I'd like to give it up for my beautiful, intelligent, sexy wife, Kira. God, you look sexy in that outfit. Can we keep it?
It was a gift from my mom.
Oh, damn. Second of all, I'd like to give it up for my homeboy, Jules. Give it up for Jules. And of course, I'd be a complete idiot if I didn't give it up for the love of his life, Nicole. Now, Julius and Nicole met roughly around the same time as Kira and I. In fact, the connection runs so deep that when Jules said he was considering proposing to Nicole on our wedding day, but thought otherwise, I said, don't be an idiot and give me that ring, because it ain't safe with you. Now remember, you gotta do it totally in costume. Totally in costume. Costume, dude.
Now, unlike someone else we all know, this will be short and sweet because I only have one question to ask. Nicole. Will you marry me?
Now you can say no if you want to, Nikki, but you know that you'll be ruining the day and everyone here will secretly hate you.
I'm sorry. This is not...
God's end, Doc.
Do you love her?
Oh, Thomas. What are you talking about?
I'm going to be completely honest with you now, Virgil. I am going to inflict upon you as torturous acts that it is possible for one man to commit upon another. Unspeakable things.
Oh, Jesus.
And then, just when you thought there was nothing left for me to do to you, I give you my word, Virgil, I will let her go. But that is not how this needs to be, Virgil, not at all. You still have control, believe it or not. You can make this stop at any point, literally, at any point. You could stop it now, if you like, before I do any of those things to you that I promised. All you have to do is say enough, and I will stop. And then I will go down there, and I will kill her.
Enough!
Excuse me.
Enough! Enough! No!
About what?
About him.
Oh?
In thinking about how long he's been doing this, he said he's been doing it for a while.
Longer than I've been with him.
And according to him, every time he does this, one person always makes it out alive. Or at least that's what he says.
That's what he says?
The thing I can't figure out is how. I mean, surely we would have heard about some lunatic who likes to torture couples. And I figured it out. He's a liar. Neither of us are getting out of here alive.
He's gonna kill us both. He always kills them both.
Not always.
How many days did you last?
2 days. I didn't even realize I'd said it. And then, when he came back upstairs, he told me I shouldn't be sad. And that I'd realized something important. Something everyone needed to. That there is no such thing as unconditional love. He told me everyone has their breaking point. And he believed he was doing good work proving this to people. He asked me to help him.
And you said yes, even though he said he'd let you go.
I couldn't admit to them that I...
So the way you cope with enforcing
you to have the love of your life killed is to help him kill mine?
Don't give me that shit! You cheated on him! You don't cheat on the love of your life! Stop! I'm sorry I upset you. I guess we all do crazy things sometimes. Better get going.
Don't let him kill us, Sims.
Come on. I'm not supposed to talk to you.
Day 4. The last full day of your life. I don't understand, Julius. All you have to say is one word, and this is all over. One word, and you won't say it. And for who, huh? Some whore who repaid your love for the first time by sleeping with your best friend. Who do you think you are? Jesus. You're absorbing sin now. You haven't got enough room in there for all of mine. So how many should there be? 40 lashes? Or do you think you can take more than the good Lord himself? Let's find out, shall we?
Hi.
Hi.
I have the rest of your stuff.
Thanks.
I know it's a cliche, but it was amazing it all fit in there.
Nothing surprises me anymore.
He called me. He only called me because he knew I'd be seeing you soon, and he says he wants to see you.
I bet he does.
I'm sorry.
I know you're sorry. You've been saying you're sorry for months. But I don't need an apology. I need the one thing you can't give me.
Julius.
Why?
I don't know.
Stop saying that! There has to be a reason. You don't just sleep with your husband's best friend because it seems like a great way to spend a couple of hours. Did you think I was doing it?
What?
Because no. I wasn't. Never.
Julius, I know.
Then why?
I don't know.
Well, maybe you're having a shitty day. You know, sex makes a shitty day better, right? You know why I think you did it? It's because you couldn't read me. You didn't know what was going to happen next. This was your one way of regaining control.
That's the stupidest reason ever, Julius. And anyway, I never said I couldn't read you.
She did. You said it on our third date.
No, I didn't. I said you were hard to read, not impossible. That's why I never really told you. I knew you already knew.
I knew you were scared. But I don't know why you've done this. Thanks for bringing my bag.
You need to control yourself.
Give me one good reason why I shouldn't just butcher you where you stand.
I was just trying to help, sir. The experiment is everything. Remember, if emotion clouds us, nobody learns anything.
Attention if he is to see it through the night. This is the end of
sweet Jesus.
Yes, me.
I do remember this. I shouldn't be having it.
Why?
Because we're not together. These memories are kind of in order. They haven't been skipping all over the place.
But this is different. Those were memories. This is a dream. Hence the reason why you're all magically fixed here. And you can go wherever and do whatever you like.
We can. Excellent.
Can we stay here, though? I do like this bit.
Of course. It's your dream. Or we could skip forward a bit to, say, the reception.
That, my dear, is a fantastic suggestion.
I gotta give it to Reggie. That whole costume thing was a good idea.
Do you think you should have done it too?
No. It already been done. I'm not a follower. Hey, can we skip forward a little bit to the sex we'll have later?
You're a little old for wet dreams. Anyway, something almost as good is coming up. What's wrong? This is a happy dream. You can't cry in happy dreams.
But am I dead? Is that what all this is? The last great dream before it's all over.
You're not dead yet.
I don't want to die. I know if I die, you die too. I know that it'll kill you.
I won't die. You know me. I'll probably bust out of there and turn that creep into ash or something.
Well, hurry up. I want you to save me. I'm probably not worth it right now. I need you to try.
Do you think I will?
Why did she do it?
know you're not her, so you'd stop pretending. I just need a second opinion.
You
want to
know what I think? I think that sometimes people do really stupid things for the most foolish of reasons. Take you. You knew that email wasn't from her, but you went anyway. Just because the possibility that it was proved too great. Now look at you. You're a bad excuse for a burger.
Music stopped.
Your song hasn't finished.
Thank you.
No, he hasn't, and he won't.
What's he have?
A friend. Let's go. Thank you. our way out.
Day 5.
Am I dead? Is that what all this is? I'm telling you, man, you just gotta be zen. Where am I?
You're in hospital, sir.
Something happened to you.
There are a few possibilities.
Nicole.
Can I see it?
Of course.
This is a dream.
It's in your mind.
It has everything to do with everything.
No, you're not her.
You can see her, but you can't hear her.
Why? Why?
That's why we're here.
See? He'd just walk away from 20 years of friendship just like that.
How kind.
You still love your ex-wife, sir.
Just be the dove.
There is no such thing as unconditional love.
He's a liar. I knew you already knew. I knew you already knew.
Do it for you, would she?
Some whore.
He called me.
Some whore.
Stop saying that.